We're getting ready to do some pigment dyeing, and what I mean by pigment dyeing is very different from traditional tie-dye and dyeing techniques. A lot of dyers have likened this process to the difference between a radish and a beet. And a radish represents pigment dyeing in that the red color on the white meat of a radish is how the paint or the pigment dye is going to sit on top of the fabric. Whereas traditional dyeing, we use Procyon MX cold water fiber reactive dyes. For our traditional dye, our Procyon dye, it actually is more like a beet in which the color is of the red beet and the outside is very similar. So the color on, if you looked at a traditionally dyed piece of fabric, the color is going to be the same on both sides. Whereas with a pigment dyed technique, the color is going to remain on one side. The advantage of using on Procyon dye like we do in our dye studio is that it'll give us very vibrant colors which are going to be very permanent and last, and the color is going to be very vibrant and beautiful. Now when we do pigment dyeing, we're going to get beautiful colors, but it's more of an aesthetic piece. Pigment dyeing works very well on an aesthetic piece like a large wall hanging or tapestry because it's not really designed to be washed and washed. There's a great benefit to doing pigment dyeing over tie dyeing, but it's a very different technique, so they suit different purposes. There are a couple of very good reasons why you would choose pigment dyeing over Procyon. And one of those reasons is if you have a chemical aversion. So if you don't want to work with around a lot of chemicals, or for health reasons you're not able to do so, you can still do some nice tie dye and get some nice effects using pigment dyeing. And the main reason is you don't need soda ash or a dye fixer to cause your chemical reaction. You don't need other chemicals like Synthrapol or urea to make your chemical water. All you need really is medium viscosity, Liquitex acrylic paint in this example, and water. Very simple procedure. Another reason you might choose pigment dyeing over traditional Procyon dyeing is that you have a lack of water, or you aren't able to have a water supply around you because you need a lot of water to do traditional dyeing. So pigment dyeing, all you really need is 8 parts of water to 1 part pigment. For example, in our 2-ounce example, we have 2 ounces here, and we would add approximately 16 to 20 ounces of water to create our dye mixture. In order to make pigment dyeing accessible to the most amount of people, I found a very nice product which works beautifully for pigment dyeing. There's a lot of things you can use, airbrush ink or any type of acrylic paint, but most acrylic paints, if you try to dissolve in water to create your dye, will not dissolve 100%, which is why we use Liquitex. I use a medium viscosity Liquitex paint, which is easily found in any art and frame store or art and craft store or on the internet. And the benefit of using Liquitex medium viscosity is that it's going to dissolve 100% in our bottle. We work with the same type of bottles as we do in other types of tie-dye, namely just a 16-ounce clear plastic bottle. I like to use the wide mouth type just because it's wider and easier to mix colors in. I'm going to add approximately 2 ounces of medium viscosity Liquitex acrylic paint to 16 ounces of water. And what I'm going to do with that is by diluting it in the water, I'm going to create a type of dye which when I put on the fabric is going to really have a nice flow. It's going to have a nice flow, but when it dries, it'll give me a little bit of hand. And what's going to happen is I'm going to dye it just like a normal dye process, just like normal tie-dye. But then being outside the sun and the air is going to draw the moisture out of our color and it's going to leave our color on the fabric. It's going to allow us to create beautifully intricate details in tie-dye and really some extravagant pieces and allow us to really make some fantastic pieces which we're not able to make using traditional tie-dye techniques. Small jars of Liquitex, just found in any frame, an art and frame store, art and craft store. It's very easy to find medium viscosity Liquitex color.